Surfers, on average, swallow 170 millilitres of seawater, about half a can of fizzy drink, every time they go surfing. But as well as this, they are also swallowing bacteria, some of which are resistant to antibiotics. So how do antibiotic-resistant bacteria end up in the sea in the first place? Anne Leonard is part of a research team at the University of Exeter Medical School, led by Dr. William Gaze.
When humans and animals are given antibiotics to treat bacterial infections, these antibiotics can select for resistance in the gut, and these resistant gut bacteria are excreted and end up in wastewater treatment plants and end up in the coastal waters.
Last year, the team published a paper looking at E. coli bacteria in coastal waters and how people doing water sports might be exposed to resistant strains.
What we found was that the proportion of E. coli that are resistant to these antibiotics was low, and that bathing waters around England and Wales are relatively clean. Despite this, however, certain water users, such as surfers, are at a particularly high risk of swallowing these resistant bacteria.
The study estimated that over 6 million water sport sessions in 2012 led to somebody swallowing a resistant strain of E. coli. Based on these results, Anne is now running something called the Beach Bum Survey.
So we're working with Surfers Against Sewage to recruit regular surfers to the Beach Bum Survey, as well as people who don't have a lot of contact with seawater. And we're asking participants to collect their own rectal swab, which will collect a sample of the bacteria from their gut, which we then analyse for the presence of resistance. We're hoping that the results of this study will tell us more about the spread of antibiotic-resistant bacteria from natural environments like the coastal zone to people. And this could be really important because there are people in the general population who are susceptible to developing infections. If they develop resistant infections, we are running out of antibiotics that are effective at treating them.